And whenever you have this runaway inflation, you're going to have resentment in the masses, as you're seeing there in Venezuela. Yes, this is the most dangerous weapon that Dajjal has today in the modern world, and that is inflation. Inflation. And three times in the Quran, Allah has prohibited it. Do you know the verse? Have you ever been told? Three times in the Quran, Allah has said, "Ba'da a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim." He says, "Wala tabkhasu an-nasa ashya'ahum." Do not diminish people's property. Do not cause the value of people's property to diminish, the value of people's labor to diminish, become smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. This is bakhs. And this is done through inflation. And the inflation has come as a consequence of the bogus monetary system. As the value of the money falls, the prices rise. So anytime they want to target a government to try to bring about regime change, they attack you with inflation. That is the most important point today in the world. It's not nuclear war at all. The most important one is inflation. So every government now is careful not to cross the line, because they know if they cross the line, the price that they will pay is inflation. And if they have inflation, the people will turn against them, and there will be revolution, and the government will be swept away. So they're all very careful to toe the line that Wall Street writes for them. This is what happened in Russia. And as the farmers stopped producing food, and as prices continued to rise above and above and above and above, it was not socialism, no, that caused the Bolshevik Revolution. Don't come with that kind of argument to me, that it was capitalism versus socialism in Soviet Union, in Russia, and the Bolshevik Revolution came because... No. It is a Zionist conspiracy to bring about a monetary system that will cause inflation. That is the cause of it. And so the regime in Russia, as 1917 approach, was becoming increasingly unpopular, and the conditions were being created, as they're trying to do it in Venezuela now, for the regime to be overthrown. And eventually, in November of 1917, the revolution took place. And then they took control of Russia. They then proceeded to establish the Soviet Union as an atheist state, so that they could destroy and dismantle the Orthodox Christian foundations of Russian society. This is my brief analysis of the Bolshevik Revolution. I want my sons, who are scholars of Islam tomorrow, and my daughters, who are going to be scholars, I want you to do your homework as I have done my homework. I'm setting the example for you, that you not only have to study the Quran and the Hadith, you also have to study the world and study history and study politics and study economics, and you must be able to integrate them all. And our point of integration here is eschatology. This is all being done so that they could further their designs in the Holy Land, so that eventually Pax Judaica would replace Pax Americana, and that a man will stand up in Jerusalem and declare, "I am the Messiah." No, he will not be the Messiah. He will be Dajjal, the false Messiah. I want to thank you once again for this.